It's not always easy, to be really so independently guided on our retreat. So it's just really amazing to see. And we know that sometimes it can be hard. So we hope everyone's doing okay, and hoping that, of course, that the gatherings on Zoom can be of some support and help you feel connected and like you're part of something and being held by all of us. So we'll do some walking again this morning. And I won't say too much more, just that, of course, there are times where it can get kind of dry, where we get sort of bored. That's normal and to be expected and something to explore. A lot of times that neutral territory of kind of boredom or aversion to neutral is something that is actually really important for us to start to kind of become familiar with and see that longing for more intensity or something, more interesting, and just that settling back into the system, into the body, into the motions that we're going through. One thing you can explore is sort of as we are doing, starting to introduce more into the seated practice of really kind of integrating a little more of the loving kindness practice as well. And just seeing like to what degree that feels supportive, to what degree it feels distracting. But just knowing that like all of these motions, the lifting of the foot, the moving of the leg, the placing, all this can be done with a sort of inclination toward kindness, towards tenderness. And you'll have to explore for yourselves what the sort of key that works at any given time might be. So is it a sort of tenderness that feels like towards the body that you're just trying to be so careful with it as you move through space? And that care has a mental, emotional quality to it, but also one that maybe we can sort of let settle into the body, that we feel it as a warmth, a kind of tenderness. Maybe it's just towards the earth, towards the ground, a sense of appreciation and gentle caressing, as we just kind of gently place our weight on the ground. Maybe it's to the things in our visual field. You can explore different things, but to understand that sometimes just bringing this quality of caring, attention, and tenderheartedness can kind of reinvigorate our sense of connection a little bit and give us a little bit more energy to do that. And to also say that you can open the attention more or less, that we've sort of encouraged this sort of focusing on the bottoms of our feet when we're walking. Opening up to the whole body, you can open up to seeing and really seeing the difference between like, oh, every little bit of object that just gets immediately identified, and to just the knowing of seeing and the knowing of that changing as you're moving through space, the hearing, the knowing of the hearing, the changes that take place in that. So we'll walk together for a little while this morning, and just feel free if you want to turn on your microphones. You can unmute yourselves, and in this way we have a little bit of a sort of shared soundscape. It's not required, but it is kind of nice. Sometimes it's like you have that sense of being together a little bit and in a different way. Of course, if there's something very interruptive that's lasting a long time that someone doesn't seem to notice, I might mute them. But other than that, you might just hear a dog bark over there, or car honk over there, and just get some a little more sense of a shared experience, which can be helpful. So feel free to do that, and feel free if it's too much, you can turn down your volume. Just expect to hear a bell at some point right before the hour. So have a good walking practice, and I'll see you out there.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, everybody. See you in a couple hours.